Hi all, welcome to another Kingscrusher Chess 24 Banter Blitz. I'm just waiting for my preview to start. Let's actually click. Right, it has started. Let's mute there. I'm trying this new board setting. Let me know what you think of this board setting. It's the third one. Here we go here, settings. It's the third one. I've seen Peter Zwidler use it. I mean, it's interesting. Just let me know. Let's see how it goes anyway. Maybe it will bring us some luck. I'm also at my dodgier internet location. If the internet goes, I'll be back in about 10 to 15 minutes. Okay, Harry. Hello. What do you think about this board? Let me know on chat, actually. What do you think about the board? All right, I am white. Yes. It's my move. E4. 1 E4. E4, best by test, Fisher says. I'm playing knight d2 to avoid a potential pin. This f5 is interesting. I'm tempted just to go for a hack attack already. Seeing that g6 and this pawn wedge could be blunting that bishop. I got my super cool glasses, by the way. These are very expensive glasses. I think I'm getting a duplicate of them for my other location. I can't be bothered to like move them around. It's for computer use. They've got a blue light preventer, which apparently might be, I don't know if they're hyping it up, it might be causing, might be good to avoid the blue light. You can pay extra for standard glasses to have that. If you're using monitors quite a lot, blue light filter. Okay, I'm going to stop knight b4. So, board setting looks good, board looks nice, in my opinion. Too contrasted, yeah. I don't know. Okay, we'll see. Okay, maybe. How can I play with it? This d6. I don't want to lose my pawn wedge necessarily. So, I'm going to keep the pawn wedge instead of the en passant. If I can play bishop b2. That's interesting. There'll be a hanging piece on g5 on h8 rather. Okay, he's undermining my d4, I guess, but there are a few weaknesses around the shop here, so I'm holding on to d4 there. Don't mind going backwards sometimes. Knight b3. Right, can I get ready to castle? I was going to play rook c8. Maybe I should have considered castling there. I can castle here. Now rook c8, king b8. Yeah, I was just thinking if he played rook c8. But now I can play king b1. Okay, let's stop this knight f4 just in case. Right, the rook's holding the knight. F4, queen's come off. Take this guy off. Maybe. I'm gonna have to go back to defend. F2 though, surely. Do I have to go back to defend f2? My knight's kind of stuck. Alright, let's take this. Let's see, rook d2, I keep losing the knight in these lines. So this is a bit of a pain, actually. Alright, this is vaguely attacking. I haven't got too many loose pieces at the moment. There's always rook c8 to queen c2. Is it worth playing f4 to get the queens off? Or queen? What about queen e3? Try and get this. I've spotted an idea. Knight e2 to f4. That would be good. Knight e2 to f4, surely. Because that hits e6. Bishop's still hemmed in. If there's one point of the pawn wedge to hem in the bishop for the moment, of course the bishop could be rerouted. Alright, at least that's improved the knight significantly. Sometimes try and improve the worst piece. Now if I actually can prepare a4, a5, so I'll protect this pawn. a4, a5, is that worth it? Maybe knight c5 coming up. Takes, it's a bit of a pointless thing at the moment. Okay, a4, b5. Or knight c5. B5 or knight c5. B5. Am I just losing a pawn there for nothing? Yes. And my king's exposed. That is not too clever. Why did I do that? The A file. This could be a disaster. Oh, bishop a3 check. Oh, almost picking up the queen. What have I done? This is crazy. I've just weakened my king for no good reason. This is absolute madness in this first game. I have to go back to the other settings. Can I do that now while in the game? I think I can. That's cool. Let's go back to the other settings. I don't think it was helping the contrast. I'm going to blame that. Okay. Knight c5 would be handy. Come on. Knight c5. This is not all bad. Knight c5 here. e5 could drop. b6 could drop. Rook b5, and there's queen b6 after. Queen c3 or rook b5. I don't know actually. Is this rook b5 at all tempting? Is it? I don't know. Probably a bad idea, actually. Bad idea by me. Unless this bishop's going to do something, it might be unlikely. This might be very optimistic. Oh, crikey. What have I done in this game? Oh, there's knight e6, maybe. Oh crikey. Am I just losing that knight? I'm just losing the knight. I've just found a way to lose the knight. What the heck? Yeah, I've played so badly. It's more badly than usual. Yeah, it's the rook down. Oh, what a game to start off with. What a bad game. Surely he can finish me off. Really gonna have a draw, are we? Unbelievable, you just finished me off. Come on, you let me off the hook. You're just a rook up. Some guts, come on, crush me. I really was messing around too much there. Okay, I'm hoping to. Is the webcam in the wrong position? I've got another B6. I was just messing around too much. Come on, I need some discipline after that. I don't know what I did there. I weakened my own king, actually. I was really optimistic. Overly optimistic. Is bishop a6 the idea? I'm not doing too well against this b6 at the moment. Bishop a6. All right, I'm not losing a piece just yet. So I'll build up bishop b2 and e5 later. You know, this board, I think I'm more comfortable with it. I kind of like the winning effect. The contrast isn't that bad, yeah. I think I'm more comfortable with it. Remember, it does affect some sort of calculation affected. I remember I played an over-the-board match with boards which didn't look that great, and I think I was demotivated actually to calculate. There's something about the aesthetics and, well, the visuals, and I know in real life, can affect things. Let's see. So here, yeah, the bishops look pretty good potentially with e5, maybe e5 coming. E5 or not to E5. Maybe the bishop should be on B1. What am I doing with the bishop there? Hold on a sec. Let's put the bishop back. E5, the problem is knight d5 to f4. Can I actually prepare things a bit better? Knight f1 to g3. Right, so the bishop is useful there already. Okay. Can I allow knight f4 for a moment? Queen e3? Alright. Take knight d5. What about knight e5 here? Oh, knight f4 is a pain. Is knight e5 any good? Try to get some sort of pin on the d-file. Let's create some weaknesses. There's knight f4 is a pain for g2. Knight e4 to f6. Knight f6. This looks like my cup of tea at the moment. If I can get a form pawn on f6. Can I get a form pawn on f6? Alright, hang on a sec. Knight f6 hits my... Alright, so I'll take it like this. I'm hitting the queen. Queen threatens... doesn't threaten mate. My queen's protecting g2 at the moment. In other words, am I winning a piece? By the way, should I adjust the webcam or not? I wonder... Why is it okay? I just want to say, is the webcam okay? Because it's a slightly different position. Oh, thanks for the game. Thanks for the game. Yeah. I think I might be winning a piece there. Okay. Hi. Okay. I'll try it. I'll try King's Gambit. Now this is a bit passive, potentially. I hope. Bishop c4. That looks like a good King's Gambit so far. Try and weaken this d5 control. Bishop g5 taking on f6 for knight d5. Or, alright, attack over here. Is there like d5 though? Don't have to worry about d5. I'm just trying to close that down, but I lose f5. Castle or bishop g1. H3. Fascinating. I'll try and do something. Queen E2. Let's see. D5. Maybe I move my bishop back. Maybe bishop F2. Knight G4. I'm not convinced in knight D5 because takes. F5 is weak. Knight B4 hits D5 and F5 is one of those dropping off. Can I do something like this to stop knight g4? Let's see if I can castle without knight g4. What about rook a4, rook a1, b4, b5? Or bishop f2 coming out? Some water here. Okay, this d5 is a bit. Yeah, so I was concerned about that. That's a pain. It makes black's position look quite good, actually. Objectively. Careful here. That's better at the moment. Space advantage. Let me support you with C5. This is really great play for my balance. Surely he should be higher rated. He's just got. Hang on. No, it's not. Wait. I could have taken on e5. I think I'm overestimating my. Hold on. e5 was just hanging there, wasn't it? Yeah, I've become a frightened rabbit here with bishop e1. Yeah, e5 was hanging. Let's not panic too. Just because of the space disadvantage, black's got to be careful as well. e5. I can play Eve. I can take this surely. If Queen D6, Knight F7, it's not a trap or anything. Okay. All right. Go back here. Okay, so it takes rook f5. This g-file's a bit of a concern, but it's okay. It looks all right now. Everything's looking a bit better. Yeah, put this bishop on this diagonal. Bishop h2. Oh, I was worried there for a moment. I thought the space wasn't looking at my possibilities. Oh, I'm getting squashed there. Wasn't looking at my possibilities. Huh? All right, I'll take that. I can take here now, can't I? Rook f6. So knight g4 coming. I'll play it anyway. Right, thanks for the game, Tail. Kaz. Close. Reload over here. Reload over here. No, I don't know. Oh, reloading over there has done the trick. Okay, that's good to know. Sorry, I reloaded on my window over there. Okay. Alright. Okay, Fenneman, we're finally in the game again. Sorry about that. It's good to know. I had another window open over there. I think that was Chrome, which is a problem. Maybe I should, if I'm using Firefox over here, I should have Firefox over there. And okay, the trick is, all right, oh, Kaz aborted. Maybe that was the solution. Kaz aborting. Okay, let's see. C5 and knight c6. Yeah, I reloaded. I don't know if the solution exactly might have been Kaz aborting. I just reloaded my other window over here, which so that might be the solution. You find all your windows and abort one of them. Reload them. All right, so knight takes and cd. Maybe this is a nice tactic. Knight takes and then cd. I'm hoping it's a nice tactic. Actually, there's bounty on this diagonal, that rook on a1 anyway. Okay. Knight d5 takes. All right, I've got a fork with knight c2 coming up. So if queen takes, I think I can fork basically with knight c2. Let's see, the check, king h8, and I'll take on a1. Well, if rook there, I'll take on e1. This looks like good news at the moment. So how does, okay, I'll take the rook then, it's protected by the bishop as well. Yeah. Tactics, guys, you gotta work on the tactics. Thanks for the game. Thanks for the game, Fenneman. Johan. Okay, I'll play d4. For a bit of variety. Let's play an h4 Grunfeld. Try and get my opponent out of book. So I don't really know that much about the Grunfeld. Try and keep the center intact. Still play for h5 maybe. I just think it's a sort of anti-Grunfeld, well, not so much anti-Grunfeld, but anti-Grunfeld tons of theory to know, I dare. Bishop e6, if he plays bishop e6, then I'm actually threatened with knight takes and my bishop's hanging. Is this a really dumb idea, bishop c4? Right, let's pin this because d4's collapsing. Yeah. Okay, I'm hoping I get some compensation for the pawn here. Might be very unlikely. H6. What about taking and then knight d5? Is that, I don't know if this is. Is this too dumb? I don't know. Rook a2. My falling to bits. A2 and B2 hanging. But on the bright side, knight B6. Is there a bright side? Rook a2, knight b6, rook b2, doesn't seem very convincing. There's always knight c7, rook knight b5 if he wants to win the bishop. In which case, maybe h6 is worth pursuing. This is another strange game I'm playing here. Strange. Rook a4 to h4. Oh no, I just blundered the bishop. He's got bishop c7. Oh, come on. Doing today? What am I doing? I didn't even notice, yeah, protecting the c7. Knight b6 losing material. I'm threatening maybe rook d6. If bishop b4, maybe I take and then knight d7. Because of knight takes d7, he plays king d8. Alright. Can I play rook a4? Okay, surely he's not going to go for a draw. Come on, guys. Two up. There's 96 here. Getting the material back. I must admit, this is, I don't know, I feel in a non-caffeinated state since last Tuesday, not the Tuesday just gone. I can't really explain it, but without coffee for several days, I feel something's up with my chest. I don't know what it is. It's like my, I'm too, I'm just not calculating very quickly at the moment. I need to get back into the caffeine regime. I tried a bit of caffeine today, banana something from Cafe Nero, and I was hoping that would put me up a bit, but I still feel as if I'm in a sort of strange, I'm in a strange state, I've got to say, without the coffee, without as much coffee as I don't want to make too many excuses, right? But I don't know. It feels a bit weird. I definitely know my bullet chess has been affected. Okay, so rook a2, rook a1. Yeah, I don't think my calculations are here. But anyway, let's pursue. Trying to put some pressure on. Knight b5. Nope. Okay, I need some sort of plan here. This isn't actually that easy at all, is it? I noticed g2 is a problem. Okay, thanks. Yeah. Okay, as almost. I should be back on the coffee next week. At least two or three coffees in the morning, maybe two, and I should be caffeinated next week. I'm sorry about this. Normal service will resume next week. I think, because then I can easily drink hot stuff. Surely soon. Soon, but today I went to Cafe Nero, as I mentioned. I just got a cold iced banana thing, and okay, that's a bit of caffeine, but I still feel I don't feel that supercharged. The supercharge button has not been pressed. My calculations, I don't know, they're all a bit dopey. This is in a dopey state, but anyway, I'm thinking f4, g4, knight g3. Because usually I would have like two cups of Kenko to kick off the day, and I haven't been doing that recently. Yeah, because there's a bit of sensitivity still, you see. I've been avoiding it since the thing, yeah. Like iced coffee, I don't even know if it has the same, you know, caffeine effect. Does it? I suppose if Red Bull does. I guess it does. Maybe I should have just had another one. Had two or something. Maybe I'll try for two. Okay, I think I'll be back to hot coffee anyway next time. Okay. Black's playing very thematically here. This is everything Black should do according to the book against this particular system. Clamp down on d4. And play for b5. It's by the book. It really is by the book. I'm impressed. No particular theoretical downsides, I think, of Black's position, I would expect. I mean, I can look for them. I guess I can look for them. EF at the right moment could be something on the diagonal. All right. I wonder about this. Hang on now. I'm wondering. I'm hitting the knight. The pawn's a bit fragmented. Black's sealing that c3 square. Oh, is it that bad? Is it that bad? I can dislocate this pawn with e5. It can be protected after takes and then bishop moves. Oh, the knight's coming there. Okay, now this e5, is it at all worth it? Or ef? I could give e5 a shot. I think he just takes and then moves the bishop. In which case, what would I do? I'm tempted to take like this to try and, I don't know, activate the bishop or double the rooks. Maybe I can just double the rooks. This knight c3 is not entirely powerful just yet. Actually, I can threaten to win the knight with bishop d5 check here. It could just sink into c3. Is it that bad? He sinks into c3. Okay. Put the queen on f3 after rook e8, maybe. That would give me queen d5. I wouldn't say nothing much is going. I would say nothing much is going on at the moment, but that is an advanced aggressive pawn on c3. All right, might be threatening queen d5. Well, I can get two rooks for the queen. That's attractive. I'm wondering. I'm taking it. My theoretical thing is kicking in. The practical thing is saying, how am I going to coordinate these pieces? But my theoretical angle on this is the two rooks should be a good deal for the queen. In this position, king's pretty safe. Queen hasn't got too many helpers immediately. I might be threatening stuff. Rook e7 on bishop d5. I'm glad the bishop's kind of hemmed in by its own pawn. So bishop d5, I think rook e7, then the queen's gonna have difficulty. Right here, rook e7 though. I can also throw in a check if needed. So queen f8, check. That would save my bishop. And then rook takes d7. And this looks very good now. Oh, so good. He was like, thank you, as I missed. Thank you. Forstad. Someone's a coffee roaster. Okay, can you let me know, this banana smoothie, okay, on Cafe Nero, would you say that has just as much caffeine as a standard Cafe Nero hot cappuccino? So cappuccino versus banana smoothie, ice smoothie with coffee, which has more caffeine? Anyone know? I'm just not feeling the coffee at all, actually. To be honest, maybe I should have had like two of them at least. I'm just not feeling caffeinated at all. Basically, my hyper accelerator for tactical calculation is just not here today. This is a coffeeless King's Crusher today. There's less of an anxiety and tension, of course, on the upside. You think it does? You think it does? I'm not feeling it. I don't know. Maybe I should have more than one. Okay. I've had far too much, maybe sugary sort of. I've had this vile-looking green stuff. This will get. They put spinach and other fruits in it. This green compressed mixture. Had that for a few days. That was vile-looking. Actually, it tasted okay. Queen D7, there's knight F6. So this D5 is causing me some pain. If I play knight E7, knight F6, king F8. The highest content of coffee is cold brewed, Harry says. All right, I'm going to allow knight F6. Because knight F6 is not checkmate, right? Bishop E6, FE. I know. Did you know that FIDE, I think, were thinking of regulating coffee for chess events? Because I think they realize it's quite useful to chess players, and they wanted chess as an Olympic sport. I think they were going to. Did you know? I don't know the exact details on that totally. But I remember reading something about it, about regulating coffee. Oh dear. Okay, I'm hitting the knight. Does anyone know about that? FIDE restrictions on coffee? Knight takes e5, so I am threatening queen f6. Okay, knight f4, can I play queen f6? On g takes, I'm wondering actually, bishop h4. Oh. Okay, can I keep the threat of queen f6? Oh. All right. Knight f4, king e7, maybe. And just try and use the g and f files. I'm hoping I'll use the G and F files. So over here and Rook G8. So Rook A to F8, Rook H to G8. He's on E6. That's total pain. Oh my god. I have to defend awkwardly. Crikey, losing B7 now. So much for the attacking plan. These knights are doing quite a good job of torturing me. Queen F7, I don't know how I extricate from this. How do I extricate? I was going for it. Opening up stuff. Okay, if we get the queens off. Maybe there's knight e3 to take d5. You never know. F6, King D7. Can I actually take D5 or not? Is the knight stuck after that? I can go back to E3. What's the threat? I can't see it, but I'll give them that on the square now. Rook D1 is on D6. Why didn't I play knight e3 just then? That would have fought the rooks. What a muppet. I had knight e3. What about this d pawn or something? Check. Oh, time pressure. Alright, thanks to the game. That was tough. Okay. Funky town. Okay. I feel I'm going to be London systems here. Nope. Oh, thank you. Don't play the. I'm going to be. This bad thing of being London system, because I think I've been talking about London system too much as a method of torture. And I've been London systemed recently too much. So I want to thank my opponent for not playing the London system. Now e5, this looks better than the bishop e2 e5, because I think I remember a game which a Fischer where someone played bishop d3 instead of bishop e2. I think Fischer got a comfortable position. Or is this just standard book standard Petrosian system? Averbark system or something. Averbark Petrosian system. Some sort of mix. Sometimes it's nice to have a knight perched on c5. Other times it's nice to have the king protecting h6 for that battery and to play for f5. The problem with the bishop on c2 though, compared to the lines of bishop e2, actually f5 is dissuaded. It's hitting my king. It's really kind of dissuaded me to play for f5 at the moment. Should it do? That's the thing. Well, that encourages me to do this, to go into that g4 square. Yeah, there does seem to be an element of discouraging f5. But with the knight on g4, can I get the king away? Because the knight's holding h6. So in other words, can I play like f5, f4, and live to tell the tale? I'm going to do that here, and even temporarily sack the pawn. If the pawn's on g6 and I play f4, I can scoop up the pawn with interest with queen e8, queen g6, getting that g file, surely. I just played it like that. My king's off the firing line, so I'm wondering e4 liberates the bishop now. And queen e8 hits h5, actually. Except I'm losing the exchange there. Okay, an emergency move to avoid losing the exchange to hit h5. It's got things like knight e4 because g4 is loose. I always played that. Right, I'll play here. I was hoping he wouldn't play something like that. F5 is loose now. I guess he can take that. is F4 and get mated on the light squares. I don't like the look of things recently, because F5 is loose. Knight E5, if Queen E1, Queen H4 for Knight F3 might simplify. Might be worth a punt. No, he just takes on H5. Okay. Bishop F6. F4. I think I'm stuck. This looks horrible. It's going off the boards. Did you see that? Is it going off the board when it says disconnect? Or was it me disconnecting? Oh, there was Queen H4 there for Knight F3. That was worth considering. Rook B2 for Knight F3. Rook B2, there's Bishop F5. Is it even worth doing that? There's Rook G8 for a moment. Threatening Queen H4 maybe. There's Knight F5 or Bishop F5 basically. Can I do this? Why didn't I play Knight F3 might have been? Okay. Things are getting worse. Yeah. Things are getting worse. Alright. Oh, things are better now, I think. I hope. E4 and Queen F3. Queen here? I'll just take, if I just take in this ending, how's this ending? It's pretty bad, I suppose. Although, it might not be entirely losing immediately with that B3 pressure. Oh. It was E3 of, yeah, I'm queening, I'm taking the rook. Fences to get me out. I was getting killed there. I was getting absolutely murders. Alright, I'm going to read up against it here. Against Pawn Grabber. It's a 3-minute game as well, huh? Try and keep it fast and furious. Queen d10, bishop h6. Stop knight f3. I'm nearly going to lose a piece here. Maybe takes with a knight to avoid d4. The pin. D4, I can take on b7. I'm wondering if am I okay here or not. Oh, maybe queen b3 check coming up. Knight f6. I think this is good for 8-8. I remember a few weeks back I missed taking a rook on 8-8. Was it more than a few weeks ago? But yeah, one of the points of the English Open is control the diagonal, not just d5, but c6, b7, a. Oh, thanks for the game, Paul Rabbit, thanks. Alright, Basti. Let's play just King's Engine attack here, or should I play something more adventurous? Just to get a start position without too much issue. It's okay, I think, to do this to get a reasonable start position. Fisher used the King's Engine attack a lot when he was younger, with great success, even against well, anyone. GMs. That was Fisher though. Okay. So I'll play knight c4 without being worried about b5 here. I'm playing knight c4 and bishop g5. Bishop g5 and I'll take it from there. Let's see what's happening here. Does he actually want to use the c5 square? No. So one plan is, once you establish a grip on e5, you can play on the dark squares a little bit more easily, generally. So I'm playing for this h4, h5 now. Knowing this bind on e5 is helpful, usually. This advanced pawn here. It's helpful usually. I might be able to afford knight h2 to g4 because e5 is held up with the knight on c4. Okay, so knight g4, f4. Alright, so knight g4, f4. F4 is out of the question now. I like the bind on e5. Can I reroute the bishop on this diagonal? To do that, I'd need to be able to play b3 for bishop a3 plan. So to do that, alright, I'll do that slowly. Or not at all. Queen f3. Let's see. I'll keep this brewing. B3, bishop c1, bishop a3 plan. So I'm holding c3 for a moment. Can Can I keep this brewing on the pot? B3, bishop c1, bishop a3. The rook's deployed defending a4 here anyway. Problem is bishop c6 might be... Yeah, I can't defend like that. How do I get this plan of the bishop to a3? Because the bishop's actually pretty useless here. Unless I'm going to sack on h6. So I'm wondering, rooks... Okay, what do I do about this c3 business? Like this. This doesn't do anything. What am I talking about, Rookie? Doesn't do anything. Hang on. Get back to this plan. Can I get back to that plan? I can't get to that plan. Wait. I can. I've seen it. This is okay. I play Queen E1. Yes, to hold C3. I play Queen E1. Then B3, Bishop C1. Okay, A5 is the target now anyway. It's moot point. A5. Just take on A5 here, surely. Maybe C4 is actually an idea. B4. Then maybe bishop C5 is an alternative to earlier plans. Isn't there a bishop hanging here of interest? Alright, I didn't see that. Okay, F7. I'm not going to take on f7, surely, because I don't like losing two. Unless here there's a check to win the rook after. So maybe f7 is on. There's a check to win the rook after. If I take queen f6, or if I take and then bishop e4 for bishop h7. Bishop e4 to go into that bishop h7. This is rook f7 here. That's queen c3. Well, there's queen e6. I don't think there's any major checks after that. So I'll try for queen e6. That looks pretty scary because I'm hitting the rook. I'm threatening discovered checks. Now, as long as there's no major check disaster over here, h4 is covered by the pawn on g3, so check, king h2, surely. That looks pretty crashing. I believe there's double check and mate. Oh, it's not mate. King f8. It's mate next move. Alright, thanks for the game. Don. I'll play a grob because I'm crazy and want variety. Okay. It's not entirely terrible as people might think, because you can get to control the d5 square, and actually the move g5 might be handy sometimes. Well, I'm hoping it's not entirely terrible. I mean, here g5 might help the d5 control. So it's like an English opening on steroids, sort of. Well, that's the plan. Is he playing for f5? a3, b4? Right, I'm hoping this g-file is something. That's interesting. Just wondering about the light squares now. I'm playing it a little bit like an English opening. I think it's got all the perks of an English opening generally. Playing for b4. Oh, this looks loose. This is c6. Queen a4 looks dangerous. Because queen e7, knight c7. Yeah, what happens on queen a4? Because queen e7, knight c7, and I take on c6. I say, one of the points in the ancient, you've got to try and exert influence. d5, c6, b7, a8, these are influence squares. As always, there's no point investing in that fianchetto. Make sure you're controlling these squares. So c6 is on target. I can win an exchange. I can take this guy first. Maybe, because d3 is a bit of a problem. Losing the bishop here might be vulnerable in my light squares. That's the thing about this. Do I do that here? Do I dare do that? I'm scared to do that, actually. When it comes down to it in this position. We'll do it and worry about it later. Oh, let's do it and worry about it later. Let's close that diagonal. Alright. Take this guy off. This light square's a, you know, shot. Maybe we can get back on the light squares there. Is he going to go for my h3 pawn soon? I expect. Yes. This is not exactly a great exchange up. Although I'm wondering, f4 was a great way of losing a pawn. Maybe I can play f5. He's going over there. Queen c2 is nearly mating me. I wanted to protect d3. Can I play for king g2? To get a bit of king safety here? Or king g1? King g2. King h1. I don't know if FG is on the cards or not. Here it looks as though it might be handy to get the rooks off. Well, this is mating. G7, rook F8 is mating. Surely. Oh, thanks for the game, Don. Alright, let's try Grob again, because I'm mad. Well, I once listened to some Basman audio tapes back in 1990 something or 80 something. It was before YouTube. I heard some Basman audio tapes whilst going to sleep. And so the Killer Grob and variations of the Killer Grob. But I played the Great Man himself with Black and Drew once. I was actually better. It's actually annotated on the Kingscrusher channel. I was Black against Basman once in the Sutton Congress, some 1990 Sutton Congress, I think. And I got the annotations for that. I lacked courage at the end to try for more. He said he was like busted and stuff. It's funny, a draw to them is like a lucky escape, but a win, if you beat an IM over the board, it's worth a lot more than a draw, basically, later. So all you chickens out there, if you ever get this good position against any IM, you know, try, just think later you'll regret it if you don't go for it. So knight e5, bishop f2, king f2. I'm doing knight e5. Here. Well, it looks as though my position's falling apart on the king side, somewhat. I'm hoping I can win d5 if nothing else soon. Fg takes, g takes, bishop d5. It's not entirely convincing. Basman got a fantastically aggressive position out of his grob, but because he knows all the stuff, it was just horrible actually for quite a while. I had to be really resourceful to try and draw it. Okay, so FG, okay, knight d5 or g5, knight b5 or g5. G5 might be something to think about whilst my kingside is falling to bits. So knight b5, knight d6, knight b5, knight d6. Well, bishop e3 looks terribly bad structurally. What about e3 for f4 maybe, or knight e2 to d4? That looks as though it might bring some stability to the position. I have a knight on either d4 or f4. F4 is possible here. Well, then d4. I'll take and suffer there a bit. If he's going to let me play knight d4, then I'll be happy. Both bishops are not killer bishops after that. If I get a knight d4 in this position. I wonder about, like, after that queen. Well, let's see. Can I play bishop a3 now? Get these pieces connected. Knight e6 for bishop d5. I just missed that. That would have been completely winning. Yep, knight e6. Yep, muppets. I missed knight e6 for bishop d5. I'll build up against d5. I've just realised I missed that. Ah, slow down, slow down. Okay, rook ad1. Do I exchange off here? Or bishop b2? Which is it? Okay, I'll keep the tension. Rook ad1, knight e6. Oh no, no. E3 is the problem now. E3 is the problem. Get out of this E3 firing line. Now! 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 Bishop d5. The classic f-pawn weakness. Alright, thanks for the game, Daniel. I could play the reverse killer grob. Kramnik student, yes. I see your comment now. I missed 96. Yes, I saw it immediately after, though. I'll play the reverse killer grob. So the reverse killer grob is the same strategy with black. So it's still about d4. It's not as crazy as... There's a lot of people that haven't got a clue about the conception of it. It is about central control, if you play it properly, right? You know, it can be a killer weapon of choice. Yeah? Because you've still got g4. It all works for central control, basically. And if you realize the trend in the last few years, I'm not making this up, there's been a big trend for inserting G4 or G5 into many opening systems. Yeah? So the influence of the grob is extremely profound on the evolution of, like, chess theory. Yeah? I might be taking things a bit far there, but no, you see G5 and G4 quite a lot, yeah? In like, there's a variation in the Slav involving a gambit with G4, which Magnus Carlsen has played at least once or twice. Okay, so let's see. A6, D6. Is my bishop subject to attack? A6, D6. Or Queen C7, not running into Knight B5. The Queen's protecting the bishop, holding up the dark squares. Oh, I'll do this. Knight F6. Pawn takes. I'm wondering about d6 to take. Okay. He's got some pressure. Wait, what did he do about this now? I don't think that was the necessarily the optimal way of playing it. He could have inflicted double pawns on me just then. G4 kind of discourages F4, the en passant. H5. Alright, well, I thought it did anyway. Probably F6. The check, I'll put my king on C7 and try and use the G file. Although rook f5 seems to trap my queen. Whoops. I've just lost my queen, haven't I? Oh, man. Okay. Rook f5 was winning the queen. Yeah? Bloody confirmation. Rook f5 was winning the queen. Get the queen out of here. Okay. Oh dear. Oh man. Oh god. Why does this look very grim? All of a sudden, I think my queen's a goner anyway. Please don't take my queen. Please. No. Ah, I knew it. Ah. Okay. Ah. No. Thank you. not looking good. Oh, that's so painful. That's really out of order. That's really out of order. Ah. Oh. I missed more incisive thing there. Maybe, I think it was check and then queen e6. Not that it matters. Yes. My poor Grob. Poor Grob. How could this happen? I've let the Grob down here. I really have. I don't think the position was that bad as it is now. I let the Grob down, I'm sorry. Okay. Whoops. Well played. Okay, I think I better play a normal opening now. After that. That was unfortunate, I don't know. I seem to be in trouble from earlier. Okay. Yeah, more stable sort of stuff. Bishop D3, Knight E5. E4 for E5. Looks okay. It's not really going to take on g3. So knight e5, bishop f4 to g5. Or bishop e5 actually. What's wrong with bishop e5 here? This looks good. Right, what's happening here? Just take here. Is it c4? It's c4 the point. Takes and then queen g5. He's got a check, I suppose. I wonder if there's b4 there, takes and is pinned. If he plays the check, I'll play b4. takes king f1. Right, queen g5 then. Queen h6. No? Is there something like a check? Is there like king d1 to stop all the checks? What do you do? Queen h6 to fire. Try and make up some racing points from the other one. If I can get this. Oh, thanks for the game. Thanks for giving me back some of my rating. Thanks. Sorry. Yeah, I needed to get some rating points back. Okay. I think queen a5, there was b4. Because if takes, there was king f1. And then there was a problem there. I think. Okay, so MGTOW. Oh no, we haven't got a technical problem here, have we? Have we got a technical problem here? Oh no. Okay. Is he around? All right. Try challenging later. Maybe. Oh crikey! Sorry about this. I do like playing him a lot. Guest member, I have to decline guest members, by the way. Okay, one of my most dangerous opponents ever on this. I wonder if I can bamboozle him now. Well, I'll try with this stuff. So a 5-minute game on this stuff. Bamboozle, a nice word. Trying to use openings which he's not totally aware of. Nor am I of the strategies. Of the appropriate strategies, maybe, to use, I hope. Of the totally optimal strategies to use against this nonsense stuff. Well, it's not total nonsense. Probably not as weakening as Grob systems. In fact, why can't I play for e5? This looks fairly dangerous. Got a nice clock edge emerging. Reasonable position in the opening. I'm hoping the bamboozlement strategy is going to do something. Actually, I've just made that word up. I've heard of the word bamboozle. I'm not sure about the word bamboozlement. Does that word actually exist? Bamboozlement. I don't know. Okay. I don't know. My rook is dumb on a2 at the moment. It's dumb looking. Whether it's completely dumb is another question. G3 and bishop g2. Alright, that was a pre-move. So, bishop c3 and rook b2. Is that any good? Bishop c3 and rook b2. Bishop c3 is knight e4. Can I actually get this bishop away from e4? Because I don't want to allow knight e4 necessarily on bishop c3, knight e4 is a pain. If the bishop moves back, bishop c3. Where does the bishop go? Does it go to D7? Uh-huh. I'm hitting that bishop. This, again, I don't know, it looks good. Maybe bishop G2 for knight C6 later. Am I weakening C4 too much? Get to play this. Is knight c6 on the cards? Now c4 is a bit too weak. Let's go back for a moment. What about knight g4? Hold on. Takes a threat knight h6. Knight g4 looks actually quite good. Is he really giving up the dark square bishop like that? Looks too dangerous for me. I wouldn't like doing that myself, to give up the light square bishop. No, dark square bishop like that. These dark squares look dodgy here. Well, swing a rook. There's rook e6. This is looking good. Knight f6. On the cards. Or bishop d3, knight g6. I think the bamboozlement has worked. Has worked. Ah, okay. That looks like a desperate move. There's knight f6. No, there isn't. Bishop's petting e8. What about knight e3? Setting a trap there. Naughty, I can win f5. He set a trap there, But this is good. Knight e7, queen f6. Knight e7 for queen f6. So I'm taking lessons from Pepe, by the way, as a commentator. He gets very excited. Knight e7, queen f6. Knight e7, queen f6. d6, d6, queen f6. Come on. Go. d6. Everything's coordinated. D6, knight e7, d6, rook f6. Rook f6, queen f6, knight h6, checkmate. Rook f6. Go. Rook f6. Rook f8, double checkmate. Goal! Sorry, I've watched too many. He's got so much energy. I love his energy, and I found that he's a PhD guy, and I think actually he's really cool. I think he's really cool. I used to think he was a bit mad, but now I really like him. Okay. Sorry about that. I got carried away. It's the energy. When I see his commentary, it wakes me up. It makes me think, you know, you're glad to be alive, yeah? You know, be glad to be alive, yeah? Okay, thanks for the game. Oh, thanks for the game, yeah. Okay, a bit I'm sorry. Oh, dear. He usually crushes me. To be fair, I was lucky today. I think I bamboozled him. would he say on the chat, bamboozled? Yes or no? Alekin, I'm going to interview Alekin now on the chat. He was bamboozled, right? I didn't understand the rat-a-tat-tat-tat, but I think it's all about energy. It's about bringing energy into the thought process, you know. Actually, I've done 1.5 hours. So I'm gonna start to be naughty now. Can we have him as the auto commentator for a bit? Yeah. Queen C8.
Knight F1.
Yeah, knight f1, Pepe, knight f1.
c5.
Yes,
c5.
g3. Bishop e3, rook c1. Bishop e3, rook c1.
Bishop a6.
Kremnik student, where are you going, Kremnik student?
Give me your pawns, baby.
Kremnik, let's play. I'm playing longer than my 1.5 hours today. Let's play. Come on, Kremnik. Where are you on the challenges list? Challenge me. There's only two challenges on pending list.
C4. Come on. Queen 2e2.
I'm playing on for a bit. It's Pepe. It's Pepe. My inspiration. Oh no. Okay. If the position's really quite a dynamic, it works with it, yeah. You know, it works to the rhythm of the position. If the position's coming, this is a bit sterile, isn't it? Okay, Queen C4. Can I not take that pawn?
Give me that.
I know.
Give me that.
I know. Although there's Knight E4.
To CA. E5. I hope you don't get crushed too soon.
No, I hope not. No, I hope he does. I hope he does, Pepe. I hope
he
does.
E4.
Okay.
Give me
get
that.
Another pawn.
Give
get
me
another
that.
Pawn.
Give it to me.
Now, you see, I used to find that annoying, but now I think it's inspirational. It's actually, just think about the energy, yeah?
Here we go. F4. Hoop! Ba-boom!
Uh-huh. Knight f6, rook e6. It's all a matter of perception. It's all about perception, how you perceive things. Yeah, and put things in context. So anyway,
Bishop 2, g5. The rook comes into action with rook f7.
Okay, this. What about the backward pawn, Pepe? You're not commenting on the backward pawn.
Give it to me.
It's enough. What about the backward pawn? It's not been mentioned.
Rook f6.
Okay. I'm getting another pawn. Yes.
Boom. Rook f5. I love this game.
Okay, rook e8.
Check. Give me your pawns, baby.
I know.
Check.
Another one bites the dust.
Knight to
g5. I'm usually the one losing all the pawns. I'm winning pawns
e5,
in this game.
Sending our little pawn to the action.
I know. Let's get
king
the king
f2.
Over. Oh! Went to the queen there.
Knight
in
f8.
My time, in his time trouble.
Give me that.
All right, I'll take all your
Boom.
Pawns. I'll
Boom.
Take all the pawns.
a7.
Okay, how many queens can I get?
Seven.
Trying to avoid the stalemate. We're in Space Invaders. Space Invaders.
D7. one more step.
All right, it's not stalemate yet. Hold on. How many queens can
King
I get here?
c4. g7. Please, let me make a queen the next move, please.
It'll be a stalemate. That wouldn't be funny. Okay, I think I'm running out of queens. I mean, I should just checkmate now.
Checkmate.
I mean, not running out of queens. I mean, I've got too many queens. That it's so many queens. It's going to be stalemate. I mean, that's what I mean.
Here we go. E4.
Okay.
Knight f3. G6.
All right, I'll let you vote. Should I turn off auto commentator or
do,
if you want to vote, I'll take it into account. let me know. Sorry, I was just giving tribute there to Pepe again. We played earlier. Oh no. Oh, sorry, we played earlier.
G5.
Oh, Gordon Bennett. It's too late to offer a bought, isn't it? Oh, I didn't notice.
I hope you don't get crushed too soon.
H3. Turn it off. Okay.
Bishop A4.
Let's turn him off. All the time. Was I lucky to draw the earlier game against them? I don't want to weaken my king too much. This looks dodgy, this position. I'll try and play knight h4. If I played this, I'm wondering, like, the bishop can sneak back and then... Ah! It could be tricky. c6. Knight c8 to b6 to c4. Knight c8 to b6 to c4. Alright, so knight e2. Let's not drop c6 in a hurry. Knight b6 to c4. Oh, he's putting me under great pressure here. I don't like this. Oh, I'm losing a pawn by force. Oh, great. I'm losing a pawn. A6, rook c8. I'm losing a pawn. I'm just losing a pawn. I don't particularly like losing pawns by force. I think my play is probably expiring. Accuracy is expiring. So I don't know. I hate losing pawn like that. Okay. F6. Try and expose D4. Is D4 a bit vulnerable? I'll be losing a pawn over here to G4 now. There's knight. Oh, hang on. He's on G6. I can't take on D4 without losing G6. This could get very painful. On the other hand, there's F2 and F4 as targets. How many challenges then? Bullet to close the show. Okay. Oh, there's Kaz as well, which had an abort. Okay, I'll try and play a bit longer today because I can actually today. I can. I'm. I can play longer today. Yeah. Is this C5 of interest? Right here. I'm wondering, especially because of rook C3, that might be C5. Maybe. I mean, you could set the exchange, I suppose. If I can get in the lovely d4, I've not only undoubled my pawns, I've created some. Oh no, I don't want to lose the bishop. It's too important. I'll just try and use this pin instead. It'd be like a check and horrible stuff after. If I can just use this lovely pin instead, without negating my king safety, without killing my king safety, trying to win an exchange pointlessly. It's all in context, I suppose. But yeah, I think the pin is stronger than the exchange, winning the exchange. It looks awkward at first sight. How is that actually? Can I keep the pin? Queen c6. Say knight d4. I can just take. Knight e7. Take here. He takes my queen. It's check. I think queen c6. I'm hoping queen c6. Knight e7. I think I just take. Takes my queen. Check. That was you, Alekin. There was someone with the same nickname as you, Alekin. We had a billet tour the other time. I remember being a queen, a knight, and bishop up. You kept playing on. I was gutted. He broke my streak. It was like, but we had some good encounters. All right, thanks, Johan. Yeah, that pin looked too nasty. Daniel Hayes. Don't tell me this is. I have no idea if I've played him before in this session. Maybe I have. I don't know. I thought someone might have been impersonating Alekin. And why? I have to ask while he's here on chat, why is it not Alekin? Why is it Alekin in? I've always wanted to ask, why is it Alekin in? Oh, is this guy? I'm sorry, I don't know. I've been playing too long. You're next, Alekin in. You're next. I'm giving you the chance for revenge at bullet. You're gonna kill my 2600 bullet rating, huh? Dark square weaknesses maybe are going to be cool here to exploit. I'm hoping they're going to be cool to exploit. There's Kaz after. There's Alekin in and Kaz in my list. Yeah, and then I'm going to stop after Kaz. Okay, I think, because that's quite a, we've done quite a bit, and I don't think I'm playing any better after 2 hours. But maybe I am. I mean, I don't know. Okay, so knight h7. Does nothing in particular. That's annoying. Alright, I'll take this just in case f7's a problem. Alright, h4? Mm-hmm. Okay, so rook h2 for knight f4. That looks like a juicy square for the knight. Also, if the knight moves here, there's knight e2 now. I'll fix this pawn for a moment, because actually that could be handy as well. There's knight d3 to bear in mind. In fact, here it might be helpful for knight over there. Might do it. To hit c2. Because the knight's blocking that pawn, it's kind of self blockaded. So knight e1, where is the pawn running to? Say after king b1. Alright, take on c2 here. Alright, so knight c1. And can I play for b4 to try and win that knight? Not so easy, is it? Not so easy. I'll move that away from the firing line. Now I'll be to try and win the knight. Alright, now knight d4 for rook b3. Oh, there's knight c2 here to win the rook. Well, at least simplify. I can flick in rook b3. Pawn. Thanks, Daniel Hayes. Thanks for the game. So, Anakin. Only 2600 on bullet. Okay. Try and pre-move the hell out of this. For a rematch, because last time didn't hear the end of it on YouTube, so well played. And I'm going to go on to the challenge thing. Well played. Okay, he's a good strong player, Kaz. Okay, Kaz, let's see, you had an abort earlier. Okay, so can I lose d4 and live to tell the tale? Rook c1, knight c5. Maybe. Bishop b1, queen d3. Or there's knight e6, maybe. No, there's bishop h2 tactic. So we watch, if I take on c6, let's try and just use this diagonal for a moment, although the f8 knight is really protecting h7. Bishop g6 as well. This is going to be tricky, isn't it? Think. Bishop a6. On the defensive. What do I do? I'm on the defensive. Oh, come on. What do I do? Where do I want my pieces? Put the knight on g3 just to shield the king. If that's not losing a centre pawn or anything. Knight f1 to g3. Alright, so bishop d3, trying to weaken the knight squares. Can I actually just use this backward pawn now? Bishop d2 and double against the backward pawn. Can I do that safely? Bishop d2, rook e2. Is that safe without getting zapped by some tactic? Ooh. Things have hotted up. Got rid of his backward pawn. Can I play queen d4? There's bishop c5. Queen d2, there's knight c4. Okay, by elimination, queen e2. I don't like the fact he got rid of his backward pawn, actually. Again, there's a tactic on. Maybe there isn't d4. I was thinking there was a tactic. I wonder if d4 is possible. d4. Bishop d2. b4. B5, queen e7. B5, queen e7. No? Maybe. Queen e4 looks like good light squares anyway at the moment. Alright, rook e8. He could force a pair of rooks off. Yes. Does he want to do that? All right, so my gum is actually getting better. I can do this without hurting. That's good, isn't it? Because it was on this side the wisdom tooth was taken out. My lack of coffee for the last 2 weeks as a result. But I think I'm going to be going on the cold coffees now. Okay, so at least too long without coffee. F3, knight e4. F3 weakens e3. Why would I want to do that? Wasn't the c6 knight hanging? Hang on. Where did that just come from? Was c6 just hanging? Let me rewind that. Hold on. No, No? Okay, I'm just imagining c6 was hanging. Alright, no, okay. Alright, knight f5 threatens queen c6 for knight e7. If rook e8, or does d3 though? Rook e8 or d3? Maybe it's worth playing knight f5 anyway, and just for that as a trap on d3. It's not such a bad trap to set. It's not even a trap. It just plays queen f5. Okay, let's get back to the plot. Well, if I take and then b5, he just plays rook takes b5. I can take and then g4 with the threat of, you know, his queen is. Okay, I'm going to do this. It threatens mate, actually. Maybe this is the better idea. And I sort out the back row here. I'm going to sort out the back row with h4. Well, I was threatening mate. Okay, anyway. I did say Kaz was the last one. I hope. Might have played some of you more than once today. And it wasn't because of me. I didn't offer the rematches. I was just trying to work through my list. It's very difficult to keep track. Does Fannerman, look, for a sense of completeness, do you want, okay. Alright, it's only a bullet game, right? Okay, if it's only a bullet game, I'll stick this on the end, okay. I feel this is a rating mismatch. Are you good at bullet, Fannerman? You're going to totally kill my rating if you did beat me. Are you playing fast enough for it? Time for commentary though. That's the problem with bullet. Not much time for commentary. It takes a real effort to do any commentary. I don't know. Knight f3. Queen h2. On that note, I better go now. Hope you enjoyed today's craziness session, ups and downs. I'm hoping to be back on the coffee next week proper. So thanks. Remember to like the video on my channel and the Chess24 channel. Have a great week. Yeah, I'll type that as well. Have a great week. Hope you enjoyed this week. See you next week. Maybe, hopefully. See you next week. All right. Cheers then. Thanks so much.